Moving away from Zeemus to Alcatel. Alcatel is looking to manufacture GSM phones in India. The company is also said to be in talks to import mobile handsets. With the telecom sector seeing a sea of reform and new financial packages, how is Alcatel hoping to cash in on this? Well, joining us here in our Delhi studio, Mr. Ravi Sharma, Managing Director of Alcatel India. Ravi, thank you so much for joining us. Is it true, are you going to manufacture GSM phones in India?
Yes. See, today the Indian market is moving very fast. Okay. I say very fast. Every month, more than a million subscribers are being added on the GSM side. Okay. Alcatel is among the top five manufacturers of GSM equipments.
Okay.
GSM phones. So we feel India is a good market for us. Okay. We are evaluating whether to manufacture in India or not, but of course we have not taken the final decision yet.
Okay, but this, you came into the market quite late compared to the Nokia of the world. Nokia is still to manufacture phones in India. You're still, but you're contemplating that.
I would basically say that we entered the Indian market at the right time. I won't say late because till last year, the most of the market which was being driven by the grey market, more than 60 to 70% market was the grey market. Today, the situation is different. If you look at the Indian telecom services market and the cellular market, more than 60% of the market which is being driven today for the cellular phones is the white market. And this is the right time when you contemplate that 1.5 million into 12, which is about 18 million phones in a year, 60% of that is the white market, which is about 10 million phones.
Okay.
I think this is the right time for us.
What is the economic size for a mobile handset manufacturing plant?
See, I think it goes, it varies from manufacturer to manufacturer and country to country. But we feel from Alcatel point of view that any time when we enter the market, we should have 10 to 15% market share, which we feel will result into 1 to 2 million phones in a year.
So is that enough to sustain a factory, or would it have to be a hub for exports as well?
I basically said that we are contemplating to see whether it is right time or right place to manufacture in India, because currently we are in the process of, we are in the business of technology enhancement. We don't manufacture it. We get it manufactured by our subcontractors.
Okay.
So we are looking at India in terms of possibility, whether that can be done.
Mr. Sharma, like you said, India is a focus area for you. I just want to get a feel of what are the expectations. I mean, I believe you've moved your region's headquarters. The operations have moved to India. Is that correct?
See, it's like this, that if you look at the worldwide scope today, India is one market which is booming. And I must say the word booming, because 2003 has been a landmark year for Indian telecom industry. Not only the policy have been put in place, and various arguments which were happening between GSM and CDMA, between grey market and white market, the service tax, the revenue share. If you basically look at it, all these problems have been sorted out. And I think now the era is beginning where all the service providers, be it BASIC, be it WLL, be it CDMA, be it GSM, all will have to get together and work together for making it, making telecom a better area for working here.
How does it affect a supplier like you? Because at one level, what we may see is consolidation, some players dying out in the service space. So does it mean less customers for you, or do you see a growing market and more, and the same, fewer number of people buying more equipment?
It's like, it's a very simple rule. We don't make money unless our customers make money. So our first priority is that our customer, who is a service provider, should do better, which they are doing. Now the second thing which I want to touch upon here is that a lot of packages, the advantages or the benefits which are being passed on to service sector, be it GSM operator or be a fixed line operator, I would feel that government of India also has to look that the India should become a manufacturing base also. If you look at China, where we keep comparing ourselves with, they have progress on both areas. They have progress on the area of service provisioning, and they have more than 300 million cellular subscribers. But they also have a big opportunity, a big base for the manufacturing setup, where they are not only covering the China market as such, but they are becoming a supplier to the worldwide. I think the similar kind of thing has to be adopted in India, because our manufacturing industry as such is very small. It's not very big. Oh. And unless those kind of benefits which are being passed on to service sectors are also passed on to the manufacturing sector, it is not going to boom. Whereas in the long term, I feel that there has to be a balance on both.
In fact, I was just coming to that, Mr. Sharma, you took my question away, but that is exactly what I was coming to, is that do you have long-term plans to manufacture not only to cater to the domestic market, but also cater to your overseas market? I mean, provided, of course, like you mentioned, government regulation is more congenial and all of that, but are there any long-term plans?
There is no problem on the regulation. I am basically talking about motivating more and more manufacturers to come here and manufacture it. If you look at Alcatel, we are manufacturing in India for last 20 years. Mm-hmm. 20 years back, we did a technology transfer with ITI, which is still manufacturing our switches, which mm-hmm. are the latest switches in the world. And we also have a factory at Gurgaon, which we established about 10 years back, where we are manufacturing again switches and some other equipments. Mm-hmm. So idea is, the point here is not that whether we will do it or not, we are doing it. But how far it can be upgraded, how far it can be moved to a higher scale is a question to be seen. And it should not be only be seen for Alcatel. I think all these manufacturers, whatever we are talking about, the telecom manufacturers, unless we bring those kind of advantages that the manufacturing company or the technology company can evaluate it vis-a-vis other countries and find India far more better.
Mr. Sharma, can I get you to just come up with some kind of numbers, either in terms of handset or in terms of revenue, that you are hoping to get out of India? Can I pin you down on that?
Okay, let me give you a different answer. I think last year we closed with about $200 million business here, because Alcatel is the only company which manufactures from undersea cable to satellite. Mm-hmm. So in different parts, we are into projects, we are into software, we are into manufacturing equipments, we are into GSM, we are into transmission, we are into whole gamut of activities for things. Like Metro Railway, we did the whole telecom backbone for that.
That's right.
So including all, we did about $200 million, which is we feel is not enough for a business like, for a country like India.
Okay.
So we are looking for a better
You spoke about ITA, you have that old tie-up big switches. There are reports that you're also going to make, negotiating with them to make handsets, is that correct?
I would not like to comment on these kind of reports, but I told you that because India is a booming market, because it is progressing at a much faster rate compared to any other country, we will contemplate, we will basically look at all possibilities.
Okay, let me just try another one. There are also talks linking your name with Videocon. Is there any...
There is a definite, it is not linking, there is a definite arrangement between us and Videocon. Videocon is one of our national distributor for telephone instruments. We are using their expertise in the field of distribution.
Okay.
They have more than 40,000
outlets. When I say linking a name, apart from distribution, anything of, you said you look at others to manufacture. Any talks with them to manufacture?
I mean, I would not be in a best position to comment on this. I would basically say that India is a market which Alcatel's focus market today. We will do each and everything, every possible thing to reach to our prime customers here. We look at India not only in terms of market, but in terms of resources. I can tell you that more than 2,000 engineers are working for Alcatel in India for the software. And this software, which is being developed here, is not only being used by the equipment as a system software for equipment, we are also developing intelligent network software here.
Okay, give us an estimate of the size, because what we've had is a huge pickup. As I said, in 2003 was a boom year for telecom. The number of subscribers added on has been huge. But has all that been done with existing investments? Will we need further investments for growth, or are the investments now in place, and will the growth only come in numbers?
See, I will share what I have data with me. Last year market in terms of investment were about $5 billion market in India.
Okay.
Out of 5 billion, the more than half was on the GSM side. The GSM phone as such, I mean, I'm talking about GSM plus CDMA phone.
Okay.
On the mobile sector itself, were more than a billion. So that is the kind of market which exists.
Okay.
And I see no reason that this market should go down.
Okay, but have the investment been made, or will have enough investment been made to propel the market, or
it doesn't happen? It doesn't happen that way.
Okay.
Because most of the companies, when they plan, they basically plan a rollout for a year or two.
Okay.
And whatever numbers they expect to get as customers, they plan more than 20 or 25% more in terms of the installed capacity.
Yeah.
So we will see that is happening. But what I can tell you is that there will be more and more investment in making that network intelligent.
One quick question, Mr. Sharma. I believe Alcatel globally manufactured around 15 million handsets.
That's right.
What share of that would India account for coming forward, say, in the next year?
I basically feel that in next 12 to 18 months, we should have at least 10 to 15% market share of the Indian market,
mm-hmm.
which will result into 1 to 2 million phones.
And also, are you looking at India as a hub for outsourcing?
Yeah, India is a big hub for outsourcing, not for manufacturing. Because manufacturing sector, I basically commented that unless there are more benefits coming to manufacture, it may or may not happen. But on the software sector, yes. And as I told you, the major change which I see in the telecoms area today for next 1 or 2 years, that all these players, be it basic, be it cellular, they will have to make their network much more intelligent. You are having a prepaid card of a GSM today. It does not offer you any flexibility whatsoever. You make a call at 12 o'clock in the night, you make a call at 6 o'clock in the morning, you pay the same rate. Whereas as a consumer, we want more and more out of that. So you would like to have a free phone on your birthday. on your marriage anniversary, and there should be a different rate for children, there should be a different rate for family, all that is possible. Sure. And we are implementing an intelligent network for BSNL. This will be the world's largest intelligent networks, which will take care of about 30 million prepaid cards.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for joining us, and all the very best. Listen, ahead in the show, find out how you should make money from the stock markets in 2000.